Patricia Van Herren, family law attorney. What do I do when my spouse refuses to get a job, even though our judgment has a Gavran warning? A Gavran warning is included in a judgment with a permanent spousal support order in order to establish a change in circumstances to later modify or terminate a spousal support award where one of the spouses refuses to become gainfully employed years after the judgment is in place. In cases where there is a failure to comply with this requirement, we can still file a request for order with the court to terminate or modify the spousal support award. In order to prepare for the case, we will set the date several months out into the future so that we can reopen discovery. We would then have our client look at available jobs over Craigslist or Indeed so that they may establish that there are available work opportunities for their former spouse. We may choose to send special interrogatories or requests for admissions, or possibly ask that the other party produce documents to establish there have been no efforts made to find a job and to become self-supporting. We will also conduct depositions so we can question the spouse about their efforts to seek employment. And this deposition transcript can be used at the time we go to court to work to modify or terminate the spousal support award. The court will look at the original factors involved in an original spousal support order, such as the age and the health of the supported party. In cases where the supported party is fairly young and certainly capable of working, the court may choose to immediately terminate the spousal support. Some people believe that they should never have to work because they were married over 10 years. The law does not support this position. Spousal support may be reduced based on the earning capacity of the supported spouse. In some cases, we may choose to have a vocational examination done so that we can have an expert testify as to the earning capacity of the supported spouse. We would show that there is work available and that the supported spouse is capable of working. The court will set your matter for either an evidentiary hearing or a trial on the earning capacity of the supported spouse. Once the case has been filed, we will also begin to negotiate with our opposing counsel and see if we can come to an agreement as to a step-down plan for the payment of spousal support. Many times, new claims are made by the supported spouse that they're ill or injured and unable to work because of this. In those cases, we may wish to retain the services of a medical expert to show that despite any alleged injury or illness, a supported spouse is fully capable of working. We can then use these experts at our hearing and present to the court our case and show the court that spousal support should be terminated based on the failure to comply with the existing Gavran warnings. If your judgment does not include such a warning, we may wish to first file a request for order so that the court may establish one and give a brief limited period for your spouse to seek gainful employment before the reduction in this in the support. In these cases, we may be requesting what is known as a Richmond order, which establishes a step-down plan for spousal support. We had a case where our client was paying a spousal support award and an additional percentage of their bonuses. We're able to establish that the supported spouse was fully capable of working. They had made no efforts to obtain employment. The courts first eliminated the Smith-Osler bonus from the spousal support award. Then a step-down order was obtained to continually reduce the spousal support payment over the next couple of years, regardless of whether the supported spouse was working. If you have any questions about the reduction in spousal support or you seek to get changes made to your existing support order, shoot us over an email or give us a call.